HVAC design is often looked at as a very complicated process. Well, if you have no idea what you're doing, it is the case. It's a dynamic system. HVAC systems, they require specific attention because poor design for HVAC systems could literally break any project that you're working on. On the other hand, if you have properly designed an HVAC system, it could actually increase the chances for a successful project completion, whether in construction, maintenance, contracting, molds, buildings, hospitals, whatever facility that you're engaging with on a day-to-day basis, HVAC system is going to be part of it, right? However, in order to have a clear idea how to design HVAC systems, we need to go from the foundations all the way to the practical expertise to get this done. In this current video, I'm going to be sharing with you a very important lecture from our premium HVAC mastery course, which will help you become a professional in HVAC design, assuming that you have no idea how to design HVAC systems, and by the end of the course, you have a clear idea how to do so, which has been attended by thousands of professionals from across the globe who are in your same shoes, who are trying to learn about HVAC design from scratch, having no idea how to do so. As a projects manager, as a mechanical engineer who has worked with HVAC systems from various backgrounds, across various projects, from various scales, from small projects to mega projects, throughout the entire life cycle of the project, from the design all the way to the installation, testing, and commissioning, I've been part of it. And let me tell you something, this course is very powerful. It's going to provide you with years worth of expertise packed in a couple hours to help you get up to speed with HVAC design. So in this current lecture, we're going to be tackling a very important part of the HVAC design process, which definitely will help you get up to speed with how to design HVAC systems, increase your knowledge base in terms of HVAC design. That way you have a clear idea how to move forward. And take a look at the video description I got for you, the links to the mastery course, as well as important links to our academy to help you join our global community of professionals and to get our latest releases and updates and premium courses and offerings. So take a look at the video description to learn more about these premium courses, specifically the HVAC Mastery course, which will surely help you out. And by the end of the course, you'll have a completion certificate to showcase your achievement. And by the way, all our programs come with a money back guarantee. Because guess what? They are quite premium, they're very powerful, but at the same time, it will give you the ability to test these programs and join our global community of thousands of professionals. These programs have been attended by chief engineers, senior engineers, heads of departments, professionals from the various walks of life, from hotels, resorts, hospitals, construction, maintenance, contracting, and the list goes on. And surely we'd welcome you to join the community as well, because this program will surely transform your HVAC design approach. So let's get this lesson started.
Welcome back. So in the previous lecture, we've learned about the design sequence for an HVAC system as part of a project as a whole. What are the key steps that you need to follow from A to Z in order to have a smooth implementation for your HVAC design, construction, and installation process. Now, in this current lecture, I'm going to just simply brief you on the essential elements that every single HVAC system should have. First of all, you do have the load calculations. In this current case, I've mentioned cooling loads because this is often the practice in the market. We tend to go for the heat removal rather than heat addition. But in some countries, you could have heating and cooling load calculations, which is the stepping stone in terms of the success for your project. There are softwares that could be used, such as HAP software. Manual calculations could be done, and there are Excel sheets that are used in the market to help you conduct cooling load calculations. Like I've mentioned, we do have a specialized course on how to do the manual load calculations by yourself. Feel free to explore it. It comes with a completion certificate as well to help you leverage your career growth and to stand out in the market. Then, following the load calculations, we do have the equipment sizing. Once you're able to properly conduct cooling load calculations, this is just simply picking up the equipment based on the types of HVAC systems lecture. Feel free to revert to that as well to select the proper size for your application. Once those are done out and out of the way, you're going to be picking up your ducts. We need to create a ducting system to help us move the air within the space from one location to another. And here what we have a manual duct sizing approach and we have a software sizing approach. Both of them, we do have courses related to that. Feel free to explore courses offerings if you are interested as a mechanical engineer to further develop your knowledge in the HVAC engineering domain. And similarly for air distribution, which is responsible for releasing the air into the space, ensuring proper mixing, spacing, and avoiding any spots without any presence of a conditioned air, you need to properly execute an air distribution system design. Since all of these are considered to be highly specialized and require specific attention and dedication in terms of the resources, the tools, the practices, the sequence of steps, they extend beyond the limits of the current course, which is tailored for mechanical engineers to be equipped with HVAC essential engineering knowledge. These are highly specialized. So if you are a mechanical engineer who's looking forward to develop even more in the field of HVAC engineering, then these are highly recommended. Feel free to explore the course offerings, which will surely help you develop and acquire those essential skills and tool sets, which will help you as a mechanical engineer stand out in the HVAC engineering domain. Now, with all of them, they come with a certification program to help you prove your accomplishment in terms of going through the work and the coursework and going through the material and acquiring the essential knowledge. So these are the essential elements that govern the HVAC practice. So we've learned about the various types of HVAC systems, the HVAC design steps and sequence, and the essential elements which comprise a complete HVAC system.
So what do you think? First of all, make sure that you smash and destroy the like and the subscribe button to stay tuned with all of these releases and updates and premium offerings, which will surely help you take your development, your skill set to a whole new level. Take a look at the video description in order to learn more about the HVAC Mastery course, which is crucial if you are serious about learning about HVAC design from scratch. We're going to assume that you have no idea about HVAC from any background whatsoever, whether you're an engineer, mechanical, electrical, civil, or you're a recent graduate high school student. Regardless, you're going to start from zero, and by the end of this powerful course, you will have years worth of expertise, which will make you stand out in the field. Even you'll be possessing knowledge that professionals who have been working for years lack. So all of this is going to be provided to you in this powerful course. All of the details are in this video description, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.